Hi, you guys. This is Christina with leadsandleverage.com, and it looks like I'm barely logging on, and guess what? We're having some wireless connection issues. I'm going to stay with you as long as possible today. I'm Christina with leadsandleverage.com, and I am coming at you today with the Rivet Show. And one of the things that we're going to talk about today, or the thing that we're going to talk about today, is a question that I was asked a couple of weeks ago, and it was by one of you guys, and you were asking me, how long should I run a test or a theory before I can call it a success or failure? And I clarified the question, and the agent was specifically talking about Facebook ads, but I thought that this would be a really good topic for us to kind of go in and talk about, not just Facebook ads, but direct mail, email marketing too. So that's what we're going to talk about today. So if you're watching this in replay, please comment below. Let me know you're with me. Let me know, you know, where you're from. I like to see where you guys are all over the country, all over the world. I love that. Let me know you're here. I am talking to you. Even if the live stream's done, I'll come back and I'll talk to you guys in conversations in the comments. So please let me know you're here and that you're watching us or watching me and live and where you're from. And so we're going to, I'm looking at my notes to make sure. The other thing it would be great if you would do, if you would click like wherever like is down there, just click like. And then at the end of the broadcast, when it ends, click live subscribe. And so you'll be notified when there are future episodes on, when I go live in the future. So you can join me live. So that's what we're doing today. So I want to go into, and if you're watching live, obviously, for my live watchers, please let me know you're here. At the end of the show, go ahead and click live subscribe. Click comment. Let me know where you're popping in from. And just, you know, if you have questions for future live streams, let me know that too. That really helps a lot. So today we're going to really going to kind of get into the concept of, if you're not really sure when to call it quits or when to scale, that's what I labeled this. I'm going to dive into how long we should run tests on Facebook ads, direct mail, and email marketing before we deem it a success or failure. That's what I'm going to talk about today. And there's really three things that we can look at that will help us with this, okay? So we're talking about Facebook ads, direct mail, email marketing, and these three things are different for each one of those, and I'll go over each one with you. So, excuse me, the very first thing is, you've got to be testing a model that is known to work. So on any of these, whether you're running ads, email marketing, or direct mail, you can't just do random stuff. If you haven't actually tested models that are known to work first, you're not going to have any foundation or any way to know if something else is going to work, because you don't have a in scientific, you don't have a baseline. You don't have a way to know. So the thing is that it's not just about, you know, ROI or good ROI. It's also, I mean, it is about ROI, but at the same time, it's not just about what we think is good or what we think is not good. We need to have some sort of baseline. So you've got to be testing a model that is known to work. So if you're going to be running a test for, let's do Facebook ads first, Facebook ads, a model that is known to work. There's a lot of people that are out there running Facebook ads. There's a lot of people out there telling you different ways to run Facebook ads. You need to be testing your ads against a model that's known to work. And there are ways to write, create, and run and test Facebook ads that are known to work. I've done live streams on them. I'll be doing more live streams on them. The second piece is direct mail. So a model that's known to work. If you're going to test direct mail, you know, and you want to know that it's successful, well, first of all, you're going to need to learn a little bit about direct mail. You really, same with ads. You're going to need to learn a little bit about ads. You're going to need to learn what actually works and then do that. Not try your own thing. Do what works first. That's where you start. So with direct mail, you'll need to know about it, but direct mail is a minimum of 12 to 18 months, and it's a minimum of twice a month. So that's a good testing point there. Facebook ads are the same thing. A really good testing point is $10 a day for 10 days to an audience you've already tested through another ad. Email marketing. Email marketing is kind of an overtime thing. You need to be listening to people outside the industry that actually have millions upon millions upon millions of emails for their stats, not opinions on people. So if you want to test a model or test one of these, you got to test a model that works. And quite frankly, email marketing, we need to do it a whole lot more than we're doing it in the real estate industry. A lot of us freak out if we do it more than once a month or more than once a week, or even once a week sounds like too much. It's not. It's not enough. So you need to know those things. You need to know in those, you got to know a model that works. Okay. Now, here's the second piece. The second piece to this. How do you know when to just chuck it all or scale it? How do you know? Well, the second piece is you cannot react or stop until the test end date that you set based on the model that you know works. So for example, one of the hardest things to do in Facebook ads, you really need to run your first ads to test for $10 a day for 10 days. So I just figure every time I'm gonna run a new ad, I know that I'm gonna spend $100 to test to make sure that the ad works over 10 days, okay? And this is in real estate and this is for localized people. If you're a bigger market, it's a little bit different budget and stuff. But when you're running that, I know I cannot touch anything. I can't change the text. I can't change the image. I can't change anything on that ad because it's not a test, not a real test if I'm doing that. So the hardest part is not changing anything during the test, but make sure you're working from a model that works. That's the key. That is the absolute key on this. The third thing when you're doing Facebook ads, email marketing, or direct mail marketing, the third thing to know when to scale or stop is really you need to do at the end of the testing period, at the end of the testing period that you've set based on the model that works, that's number one, you need to debrief. And you need to debrief in a way that you find the successes and the failures, because in everything, there is both. You learn something, both good and to do, to repeat, and to not do and not repeat. So you need to have a good debrief session. So here's a little bit of stuff for ads, for direct mail, for email marketing. You've got to have a model that works, okay? For all of those, you need to follow a model that works. If you're doing one-off or one-hit wonders or things that I call them that, those one-off things or those one-hit wonders, if that's what you're doing, just waste your money. Keep wasting your money. Keep spending it on crap. You need to have a model that works. This is a long-term process. It's a long-term system. If you do your advertising, your marketing in the right way, you're going to get good leads and you're going to get quality leads, and they're never going to stop. The faucet will always be on. And even better than that, regardless of how the market shifts, you're going to be positioned because you're going to know your audience, be targeting your audience, have already tested it. You're going to be positioned to shift with the market. So you need to have a model that works. Like I said, you need to have a Facebook ads model that works. You need to have an email marketing model that works, and you need to have a direct mail model that works. You need to know that it works. You need to not be listening to your colleagues around the country that say what they like or don't like. You need to not be listening to your colleagues around the country that say what worked for them and what didn't work for them. Let's be honest here, you guys. Most of us who are sharing in these groups, we're not really, we say we're trying these things or we've tried everything or we've done it. That's crap. We haven't actually done it. When agents tell me, oh, I did direct mail and I didn't get anything from it, I know for a fact, 100% sure, they did not actually do a test. They did not actually do a direct mail campaign. They probably sent out one letter or one postcard that said, woohoo, look at me, or woohoo, look at these stats, or woohoo, look at this house. One time. Of course it's not going to work, because that is not a model that works. So we cannot listen to these people in these Facebook groups who haven't actually implemented working models in their market. So when I say you need to look for a model that works, when I say you need to look for a model that works, you guys, I mean you actually need to look for a model that works, not from fellow agents. And here's the other thing. Most of us, we're not tracking anything. Most of us don't even keep track of our leads or our past clients. We have them on contracts and copies of contracts, and they're random everywhere. We don't even have a database. So if we don't even have a database, how can we rely on the stats that we're spouting in the groups as fact? The results of things that we've done. We can't. So we need to step outside and find models that actually work. So there are models for Facebook ads. There are models for direct mail. There are models for email marketing that actually work. And by work, I mean that move people along the, so for ads, bring people in that you don't know. They also help convert people that you do know. For email marketing is number two, email marketing. It moves people on that customer journey with you, that nurture process that can take anywhere from 2 days to 54 months. That's the longest one we've ever had in the process so far. And the other thing is direct mail. You know, there are processes that we know that are out there that work, and we just, I don't know why we tend to think that we can do these one-offs and get these random cherry pickers. You know, we want to be the cherry picker. We want to take the stuff that's on the bottom. And when we don't implement models that work, for some reason, we're thinking we're kind of the exception to the rule, or, oh, hey, I've got such a great thing. It's going to work better. But here's the thing, we end up wasting a lot of time and money when we don't actually follow models that work. So my big thing on this is you gotta be testing a model that actually works first. One of the biggest things I teach inside Facebook Domination Secret is to follow what I teach first. Get yourself set up on something we know works all over the world in all of these industries, and then start tweaking it for your market. But then you'll know, oh, this is working, but I'm doing this test and it's not working. Okay, let's go back to the model and then let's test from there again. So that is really the biggest key, you guys, following a model that works. The second one, this one's the hardest one for me, the absolute hardest one for me. I like instant results. I think everybody does. I like instant results. Oh, it doesn't matter whether I'm, you know, gonna want to lose some weight, or I want to work out and get fit, or I'm gonna send a direct mail campaign or do a Facebook ad. I want instant results. I think we all do. But here's the deal. We need to be following that model and setting that test period and not doing anything about changes. Just keep following the model. So we need to focus on the process, not the outcome. And that's our problem. That's my problem sometimes. I'm just focused on the outcome. I want the results. And I need to be focusing on the process. Okay, what do I need to do today and today and today? So we need to, we cannot change. We cannot react or stop our test following the model that works until the test end date that we've set. So for Facebook ads, minimum test is $10 a day for 10 consecutive days. Not fancy times on there, 10 24-hour periods, okay? For direct mail, it's a minimum of 12 months, ideally 18 months, at least twice a month, if not more. For email marketing, it's a minimum of once a week. Those are good tests. And the email marketing is like forever. That just goes on forever. So those are the minimum test periods for all those, but we don't follow those. We're not consistent. I'm not sure what we're searching for, but it's something different, something that we think is easier. And these are kind of foundational basics. I mean, I think it's funny that Facebook ads are now considered a foundational basic. But they are, because they're not going anywhere, guys. And it's just, they're becoming more powerful. They're helping drive two things. The other thing, I didn't even talk about this on here, but blogging. How long should we be blogging? And guys, forever. Here's a perfect example. I started the leadsandleverage.com blog in October of 2013. And it's the very end of June of 2016. So almost about two and three quarters years. I wrote an article for Inman in the very early spring of 2014. I think it was January or March of 2014. Just last week, that article that I wrote almost 2.5 years ago went crazy viral. Someone found it who had a really wide audience, and it went nuts everywhere. It's almost a 3-year-old article. So my point with this is we can't just be back looking at going, "Who? I didn't get the reactions or whatever, or the results that I wanted," because we know that blogging is a long-term program, a long-term system. It's a foundation. So when you're looking at these things for ads, for direct mail, for email marketing, for blogging, I added that on. When you're looking at these, you need to realize that it's the process and then the outcome is in the future and the outcome's going to happen, but you need to have that process and you need to be following a model that works. And again, number three, the debrief. The debrief. The debrief is not just about how many deals did I get. The debrief is what went wrong? What can we change? What went well? What should we increase or leverage more of? It's really, there's always a good and there's always a bad. And we need to take those pieces, not nitpick ourselves to death, but take the general, the big pieces of that and go, okay, we need to scale this. We need to do this piece better. We need to debrief. So I think sometimes as real estate agents, we don't really want to get into that. We don't want to get into understanding the models that work. First of all, we just want to put a letter out there or put a postcard out there or put an ad out there and we want leads. Well, the thing is we got to understand it. We don't have to understand every single minute detail, but we do need to understand what the heck we're doing. And, you know, we know why we're doing it, but we need to understand how doing this at point A is going to get us to point Z. We need to understand that process. So that's a big thing that we don't do. That's why I really, really push following a model that works, because we spend a lot of money testing all these things, testing the stuff that vendors are throwing out. We test snail mail stuff. We test ads everywhere on Facebook, offline, etc. We still test billboards. We still test bus benches. We still test shopping carts. We still test all these things. And we don't have a real system or understanding of, okay, I'm doing this. How is it going to get me here? We just kind of hope. We listen to the ad people that are selling us these spaces and this stuff who say, well, it's going to get this much reach or this many people are going to see it. Well, guys, it doesn't matter if those people are 12. It doesn't matter how many 12-year-olds or 14-year-olds are going to see it. What you need to see, what you need to know is, okay, who's my target market? Are they going to see it? Are they ready to buy or sell? Are they going to react to it? So we have all of these things. And is it long enough? When you're going for exposure campaigns, stupidest way to go for business, just letting you know, going for exposure or name awareness, you need to spend a lot of money and never, ever stop. And it needs to be on everything. I'm talking everything. You need to be everywhere. And not only that, it's still going to spend a lot, cost you a lot of money, because you're going to miss a whole bunch of people because you have no call to action, no targeting, and no reason for them to know, like, or trust you. They're just going to see your face everywhere. So yeah, sorry, that was a little rant on that. But my point is, you've got to follow a model that works. You cannot stop. You can't shortchange the testing process. You need to keep going regardless of the results during the testing process. And then you need to debrief. The third one is you need to debrief the good and the bad and figure out what not to do in the future and what to increase and do more of in the future. So this was Christina, or I still am Christina, with leadsandleverage.com. Came at you today with The Ribbit Show, talking about how long to run a test or a theory before I call it a success or failure. So I went over quite a bit on this. If you have questions, you're watching this in replay or watching this live, and you have questions for me about this topic or any variation of this topic or others, please put them in comments. I am taking your questions. I will go deeper in future episodes of The Ribbit Show. I do this every day that my internet lets me. I do this every day, Monday through Friday. So I want to help you guys. So just let me know your comments, your questions. If you want me to go deeper on something, absolutely. I'll put that in a future episode. Okay. Thank you so much, you guys, for being with me. This is a particularly shorter one. Mostly because I'm trying to beat our internet technician who's going to come, and our internet's having some issues and he's going to come and fix our internet. So I wanted to get this in and get this out there for you guys, to get this help out there. But I also didn't want to get interrupted by our internet going down. So, you know, it's a juggling process. Thank you for joining me. Awesome. Let me know you're here. Let me know in comments that you're here, where you're from, and let me know your questions. I want to help you. Have a fabulous afternoon, you guys.